Wait, what's happening, mate? You're recording. I should be recording now. Okay, hello and welcome back to Random Game Plan Days. In today's episode, we're playing Dr. Frank's Build-A-Boyfriend. I saw this game and decided, you know what, this would be a funny one to play. So we might as well hop right in. I do have a timer set, so I don't overplay the time. Once upon a time, in the treacherous mountain hillside of Glenel, or Glenel, there lived a wondrous, amazing, and most incredible scientist named Dr. Frank. And yes, he was a doctor. He finished like half or both his doctorates before he got kicked out. That totally counts. Can everyone lay off about this? Anyway, the super awesome Dr. Frank. I was almost saying Dr. Frank. Spent his days toiling away at his research, pursuing his lifelong dream of bringing people back from the dead. It wasn't for any sentimental reason, there wasn't some long-lost loved one he wanted to bring back or anything. No, this was for a much more noble pursuit, the aim of advancing mankind's scientific knowledge. And yet, it was the same research that caused the local villagers, and even the weak-minded university men to fear him, because they were stupid and jerks and they couldn't possibly understand the sheer genius of Dr. Frank's work. But it was no matter, for the genius doctor was an honorable and humble man who simply continued this critical research, even if it meant he was completely alone. Well, okay, he wasn't totally alone. Iggs was there. And he was a fine assistant, even though he keeps asking for raises. The point is, one day a sudden knock came at the door, and the scientist opened it to find a beautiful man with a radiant glow standing there. In his heart, he felt strange, previously unknown feeling to begin to form. As the man opened his mouth and said, "Yo, what's up? Name's Dominic. You're that freak that got kicked out of Hindenburg University for those weird death experiments, right?" It was like an angel had been sent to him, and now that angel was asking about his research. No matter what Dr. Frank did, he couldn't help stop his heart from pounding. The good doctor invited the man in, and they quickly got to know each other. And as days passed, and the man's visits grew longer and longer, their relationship also grew into something romantic. Dr. Frank had never given his heart to anyone before, but maybe for him, maybe for this man, Dominic. 3 months later, they broke up, probably. I never want to see another beautiful boy ever again. Dr. Frank, are you still in there? No one is here to take your call. Please leave a message after the tone. The door opens and my assistant Iggs walks into the room. I try to bury myself further into the sheets, hoping that maybe he won't see me. Instead, he rudely opens the blinds. It's been a week, Dr. Frank, so I can't be sad as long as I want. I lost the love of my life, Frank, Doctor. He waves his arms in the air out of frustration. Look, I know he meant a lot to you. I mean, he was your first, right? And no one likes being dumped, especially when it was out, too out of the blue, like that. But sitting in your room all day crying into your bed sheets isn't going to help you recover. You need to leave me alone. He said I was cute and I was in love. He was my boyfriend. He couldn't possibly know what I'm going through. Actually, Dr. Frank, I've gone through a fair share of breakups myself. You do know how I met my current boyfriend, right? So yes. I think I do know what you're... How could you say that to me? My love was special, unique. It wasn't like your love. It was my destiny. Oh, it's just, you know, full of comedy, I tell you. Never give up. I think he's given up. Number one best. Just made that out from crayons, I tell you. I roll further into my blankets, breaking my sight line with this egregious interloper. I can never say that word, I tell you. I don't get paid enough for this. Dr. Frank. He starts to pull the blanket from off the bed, against which I double my rolling efforts to keep him busy at bay. I didn't come in here to fight with you. Can you stop? We have a problem. I can feel his grip lessen, and I peek my head out from the blanket cocoon to look at him. He's holding a piece of paper in his hands, with a weird look on his face. I tentatively grab it and start reading. Tomorrow's the Hindenburg University Conference. You know, the one people travel from all over the country to see. Well, the conference schedule was posted today. And... what? What is this? Right in front of me, in plain letters, is Returning from Death to Life, a breakthrough study by Dominic Nilon. Resurrection? But that's my research. But it's Dominic presenting it. This can't be right. He wouldn't be presenting my research. And under his own name. I tried to tell you last week that I noticed him leaving with some folders the day he dumped you. But you were too busy crying into a gallon tub of ice cream to listen. No, this couldn't. That butt. First he breaks my heart and dumps me out of the blue. And even after he called me babe. I mean, how could he say that and then do this? He takes my research, my baby. And now he's presenting it to those terrible people at the Hindenburg University. Like they hadn't rejected my exact proposals years before. Why did he get accepted while I was kicked out? Well, your thesis project did bite the headmaster's hand clean off, Dr. Frank. It was one time. Well, he has two hands, but you know, two hands is, you know, a lot of hands, you know, normal hands, but you know, one hand con, you know, that's 50%. Yeah, whatever. That's not important right now. What's important is that Dominic is about to claim my research as his own. Maybe this was his plan all along. I mean, but we were soulmates. I just knew we were. But now I don't know. I crumpled the paper in my hands, riffing with angst. There's no way I'm going to let him get away with this. That butt ruined my life. He's taken my baby, my research. I throw the blanket off of me, leap into my feet. Eggs! Yes, doctor. Get the shovel. I'm going to show that butt what happens when you singy off a scientist. Later that night. Frank, doctor. Dr. Frank. I'm pretty sure this is illegal. I look up at him, holding a particular interesting specimen in my hand. Does this look like the arm of a hot boy to you? This is illegal. A lightning strike touches down a good whiles off, as if to exaggerate his statement. No one's using these, it's fine. We are desecrating graves. Like, if this was, you know, Edgar Allan Poe's body, you know, that got stolen, but they didn't really care too much about it, but they did get the body back, but, you know. No one cared when, you know, Abraham Lincoln's body got stolen, so I'm not sure they're gonna really care too much unless, you know, a family puts money in to try and, you know, track down who, you know, stole their, you know, family's grave. You're like, yeah, it is illegal, but, you know, still. We're desecrating graves. I mean, I've helped you with a lot of your crazier experiments, but this is where I draw the line. I throw the arm I'm holding to him, quickly climbing out of the grave. Nah. So yeah, maybe there's a chance this isn't completely real. But this is a historical moment, Ix. If we are going to create the first artificial life form and show up that bunt and those idiots at the university, we can't skimp on anything. We are not just making the world's first artificial life form here. We're pushing the boundaries of human capabilities. We're going to create the world's hottest boy. And then Dominic will take one look at him and realize that he was a fool for leaving me, and even a bigger fool for taking my research, because now I have someone even hotter than him. How honorable, Dr. Frank. Iggs appears to be trying to find the perfect position to hold the specimen up with the least amount of bodily contact. So you see, people who advance the boundaries of human capability were never stopped by silly things like laws. Now quick, I heard that Mr. Lanz had a pretty... We can use that. Suddenly something moves under the brush, in the brush. Eek, what's that? Hey, watch what you're doing, what you almost dropped our precious spoils. But you didn't hear that, Dr. Frank? I think it was something. Again, the noise breaks out from behind us. Well then, hurry up and find that Dr. Frank, behind you! I quickly spin around, and suddenly an ominous feeling in the pit of my stomach. There's a man I've never seen before standing there. I'm sorry, was I disturbing something? No. Step back into X, hoping that the stranger can't see any of our souvenirs. I'm so sorry, it was his idea. I punch him quickly before he can say something stupid. This causes him to recoil, and the arm we had been arguing over not a few minutes earlier lands on the ground with a loud thud. The man takes a clear look at what dropped on the ground and looks back at me. What was his idea? The man takes a step closer to us. I quickly position myself in front of the dropped arm, holding my breath. Eggs! You're so funny, such a kidder! Well, it sure is cold out here. All of a sudden, well, we should be going. I grab our bag of loot and dash away as fast as my legs can take me. Iggs yelling after me, telling me to slow down. It was nice to meet you, Dr. Frank. Maybe that's the one that, you know, other person made. If I get arrested, I'm suing you. I dumped the bags contents. Onto the table, body parts flying out and bouncing all over the floor. Said I'm going to sue you. I think we have just enough. Dr. Frank, do we even need all of these? Why did you take so many to begin with? Iggs, we are making art here. We can't just use body parts, part we find. We must only use the absolute most beautiful pieces. I pick up some arms to take a closer look. Like this, see? They're absolute gorgeous. Look at that keratin. Or actually, not as beautiful as the one you dropped. But I suppose you're right, they're beautiful enough. You say that as if I dropped it on my own free will. I'm not, because someone punched me. Now where did we put the poop. I turned to look at my assistant. We have a problem. Like, how we desecrated dozens of graves, hacked off and stole family members' body parts, and then we're spotted, so doing so. Well, no, not that. We... I pause unsure of how to say this. We didn't grab any, you know. Gesture downward shyly, hoping he'll get the reference. I have no idea what you're trying to say. We didn't grab any, singies. Oh, well. This is terrible. We even had the perfect specimen with Mr. Lancey's. How am I supposed to make Dominic jealous of me now? Dr. Frank, do you honestly think that is what is going to make Dominic jealous of you? Yes. We need to go back. Absolutely not. He blocks my exit, making sure I can't retrieve any other body parts. We don't have time for this. Fine. We need to, I hate saying this. I'll just have to improvise, I cannot speak it out. I don't like where this is going. It's fine, it's totally fine. We're still making something beautiful here. We just need to be creative. Let our creativity juicy slow. Now let's see. It's the Three Stooges. Okay, we'll create a William Wallace kind of looking guy. Okay, we confirm. Perfect. Dr. Frank, what were those thingy options just now? Iggs, open the roof doors. I need a little atmosphere as I make history here. He suddenly goes to crank the reluctantly begin. Okay. He sullenly goes to the crank reluctantly, beginning to turn it. The ceiling creaks open, showing the dark, turbulent skies and cold, harsh rain above us. I raise my arms, catching. You just gotta get wet and then you gotta get electrocuted. Catching the coldness in my outstretched hands. There's a strange sensation in my stomach, a knotting of excitement and anger. It's rising throughout my body, invigorating me with a newfound strength. X, this is it. It's perfect disguise. They know that we're about to do the impossible. They know what we're about to do. Nothing can stop me. Nothing can stop us. I am going to show Dominic that I don't need him. That I'll never need anyone like him in my life ever again. He and his kind will become obsolete. We're going to better the world, Iggs. We're going to make it so that no one will ever have their heart broken again. Dr. Frank, you're scaring me. I can do this. I can make the most beautiful boyfriend ever. That absolutely blew my eardrums there. We worked hard through the night, communicating enough juice and energy from the light and storm to inject into our subject. We almost failed multiple times, the body not holding the energy as well as it should. But it was no matter. My sheer genius, hard work, and determination carried us through the many hours of grueling surgery. We have done it. We had created the world's most beautiful boy. I love how there's just nothing down there now. Dr. Frank, he's kinda ugly. Don't say that to him. You'll hurt his feelings. And I'm sure he's beautiful to someone. No, what am I thinking? I made him. He's beautiful. And beauty is relative. Anyway. Of course. Especially with his, what exactly is that on his abdomen? It's his 128 pack. I figured that the more packs you have, the thingy you are. So I did a lot. Frank, Doctor. Dr. Frank, you took a anatomy class, right? Cop, well, I guess, technically. Maybe. I don't even know what to say. He spoke. Do you hear that, Ix? My boyfriend spoke. Your what? My boyfriend. Haven't I been saying that this whole time? You've been saying you were going to make a boyfriend, not your boyfriend. Of course, I'm making my ultimate boyfriend. Look at us. I wrap my arms around the monster to show Iggs what I mean. He's soft. He returns the hug, lifting me off the ground and nearly breaking my bones in the process. Gah, see, I can't breathe. He's so strong that's, you know, singing right. Monster, drop him. You drop him right now. Monster, let's go of me. I painfully hit the ground. Dr. Frank, are you alright? Of course. Because my boyfriend just hugged me. Dr. Frank, please stop. Cute. Ix, did you just hear that? Please calm down, Dr. Frank. He's a perfect boyfriend. Ix, look. Okay, look. I ran up next to my boyfriend, wrapping my arm around his waist. Do we look good together? Like, would this make Dominic jealous? I don't know if jealous is the word for it. The monster then leans over and gives me another hug. This time, not as painful. Aww, he's a hugger. That's the best ultimate boyfriend. Papa is soft. Please don't call me that. I love my papa. Please stop. That must be a glitch. Papa is soft. No. I'm your boyfriend, repeat me after me. BOYFRIEND. Papa likes hugs. Dr. Franks. Please make him stop. Don't worry. We can drain him out of that. Probably. That'll probably take some time. Which, well, we probably don't have. Doesn't matter. As long as he doesn't talk, it should be fine. He can still be my boyfriend. And let's get moving. Anyway. I love, you know, the hair just being so stupid on him. If we leave now, we can easily make it to the university square before the presentation starts. Boyfriend, let's go. We're going on a field trip. Yay, field trip. I begin to lead him by hand, wondering how we were going to navigate the narrow stairs leading from my secret lab. Surely you're not going to take him into town like that. What do you mean? Well, he's naked. How else are they going to see his beauty, Ned? He's going to get arrested for public indecency before you can even make it to the conference. Fair point. And so we'll dress him. I made him pretty big. You did? I'm not sure if I have any clothes that fit him. Dr. Frank, you need to dress him. Okay. I guess I'll just be creative. Dress your boyfriend. Leave him undressed. I best assortment of worn clothes. I still have a while until laundry dry. Laundry day. The only thing that would fit my monster would be checks itself before wrecks itself. I pick up my old nightshirt. Perfect, this is fit. But I'm still missing some clothes articles. None of these pants will fit them. I don't want to open these. The skeletons I have stored in here are going to fall out. Packing was never my strong suit. Entryway. This random assortment of shoes are all footwear I own. None of these would fit the monster though. Naturally, his feet are really big. Shoot, but what am I supposed to do? The only person who would have shoes that fit him is Dominic. He'd left behind a pair of his shoes after the breakup. But in a rare fit of rage, I had thrown them, alongside with all of other stuff, inside the entryway cupboard and threw away the key. Poop. I made this for midterm project. We were supposed to weed killer. Ended up creating something that makes weeds grow at a almost comical rate. On top of that, I'm either deathly allergic to this, or it's poison. Either way, I don't want to pick this up unless I need to. Pick it up. Yes, please. Holding my nose, I pick it up into my achoo. Oh, this sucks. No, I loved embrace death. I collect up broken parts. Nope, nothing there. It's Susie, my thesis project from PhD program. He's named after the black-eyed Susan. Look, I built him specifically lust after the flesh of man. Yes, he's going to bite. That's kind of his nature. There was no need for him to kick me out of the program for it, and he even only bit someone once. That's pretty good for a man-eating plant. Study. Achoo. Ventilation in this room isn't very good. Suddenly, I become aware of foul odor. The weed killer in my pocket put an off. Achoo, achoo. Get. Collapse the ground, gasp for it. You died. Try again. No, I'll stay dead, thank you. Alright. Poop. I guess that's the end. Have a nice day, safe, hope it's possible. Moves, horses, think it's very fun, it's very important. I'm a nice day, thanks, I'm a nice day, bye bye.